This is a Storm 12 alert.
Hey there, what's going on? Facebook Live here. We are now at 4:27 here on a Monday evening here. We are getting geared up for the remnants of Ida to move into parts of Middle Tennessee and for Southern Kentucky here. First up here, want to kind of get you updated on what's happening here on the weather front. We've got some storms out there right now they're not severe right now. They're staying below severe limits. So there are behave storms that are moving through parts of the area. The first one here, we've got a strong thunderstorm that will impact portions of Davidson County, also the northeastern Rutherford County, southwestern Sumner County, and the central Wilson counties out there through 5 p.m. time frame. So if you haven't got anything yet, storms are on the way to parts of Sumner County, Rutherford County, Davidson County. I'm going to show you radar here in just a few moments here because I want you to be mindful of what's going on out there on the weather front. So again, like I said, the winds with these 30-mile-per-hour wind gusts, we are not looking at any hail with this, but we are looking at some pretty hefty downpours out there right now. Also, we got another strong thunderstorm that will impact portions of the southwestern Macon County, also the central Trousdale counties through 4:45 this evening here. So we're continuing to watch this there with the system. With that, we're talking about winds 30 miles per hour there. I know you're seeing people come in studio, all right? They're just running in and out here, all right? So let me show you radar really quickly here. Let's get you up to date with radar because that's the most important thing of it all, because I know a lot of you have had questions. A lot of you have hit me up on social media asking, all right, Lorante, what's Ida looking like? Here's a look at radar right now. This is a live look at radar right now. There you'll know we've got some areas of some showers. Some of these are producing winds of 30 miles per hour here, especially areas south of Nashville right now. Forest Hills, Franklin, Spring Hill, you're getting some of these showers moving through parts of the area right now. Murfreesboro, same for you as well. And then we've got a little system over here in the Hartsville area right now that is producing just some normal heavy rain with it. Winds 30 miles per hour is possible with these. But I want to show you the bigger picture here. First off, this is a look at the marginal risk. This is the marginal risk for today. It would not surprise me if we get upgraded to a slight risk for our area for tomorrow, overnight into tomorrow. We'll have to watch that very, very carefully here. And let me know what you guys are seeing outside right now. I know Rana is saying that there's no rain currently active right now in Gallatin right now. But I will tell you here, there we go. Radar just updated there. Radar is not indicating any rain moving through parts of Gallatin just yet. But hey, be mindful there that there is some showers and storms that are on the way. We are not going to be rain free from this at all. You can see the tracks of these are moving up north, impacting parts of Franklin, Spring Hill. You're next in line with this. Let's see here. We got a track here that's going to be impacting folks in parts of the White Bluff area. Cheatham County maybe getting in a little bit on this action, a little bit of the northern part of Dixon County getting in on this action. I should say the northeastern part of Dixon County getting in on some of that action out there. We'll take a look at the broader picture here. I'll zoom radar out here and you can see the rain is here. Here's a look. This was what we had across the area. This is still coming from Ida. For those of you that don't know, Ida was a Category 4 storm that did move across the area, causing flash flood warnings across the area, especially in parts of New Orleans, Louisiana area. We have saw quite enough in that area, and this is all going to move to our area. This is why we have a Storm 12 alert that is in play starting tonight at 7 o'clock and will expire on Wednesday. Wednesday, we're looking at just some normal showers out there, but and then by Wednesday afternoon, we're looking at better conditions across the area. But again, you'll note flash flood warnings are still posted across the area. The yellow area that you see here, that is where we have a slight risk. That is a 15% chance of seeing some strong storms across the area.
And then again, this green arrow that you see here, that's where we have that marginal risk. We've got a severe thunderstorm warning. That is not in our viewing area that we are currently watching for. One thing I do want to kind of point here, let's talk about what we're going to expect. So as far as tornadoes go, you can really tell we're really not looking at a tornado threat here, but again, a few quick spin-up tornadoes is totally not out of the question here. You can tell the arrow, the kind of the dark arrow here, that's where we could see any quick spin-up tornadoes in parts of the area. Like I said, this is something that we'll have to watch very, very carefully as it continues to churn its way right into Middle Tennessee, bringing us a threat for possible quick spin-up tornadoes and also some flooding as well. So that's a look at the tornado. Let's take a look at some of the hail indications, and really not seeing any way of hail that's been producing in some of these systems here. No hail as of right now. Haven't gotten any reports of any hail, but I do want to show you the wind though, because the wind is something that we've been watching for. Wind is another thing that's going to be a primary issue here, along with the possibility of some tornadoes as well. But again, I'll show you radar one more time here. If you're in Nashville, get ready for it, because I'm telling you, it is coming. It's coming right to you. It's coming right. It's probably knocking on a lot of y'all's doorsteps right now. So that's a live look at radar right now. And then let's see here. Haven't got any reports, storm reports right now, that have came in just yet. A lot of these you'll see is winds, maybe some knocked over trash cans, some showers and storms, very strong storms moving through. But notice, all quiet right now. These are non-severe storms that are moving through, parts of our area right now. Let's see here. We've got a special weather statement here. Here's that one of those special weather statements here that you can kind of see. I just kind of circled it so you can kind of see it there. Those are one of the special weather statements that we're watching for. And that is for parts of Lebanon, Nashville, Madison, Hendersonville, Smyrna, Laverne, Mount Juliet, Goodlettsville, Oak Hill, Belmead, Lakewood, Hermitage, Rural Hill, Antioch, Belinda City, Old Hickory, Jolton, Walter Hill, Berry Hill, and Cedars of Lebanon State Park. This also includes Interstate 40 between mile markers 201 and 242, Interstate 65 between mile markers 78 and 98 as well, Interstate 24 between mile markers 34 and 59, also Interstate 840 between mile markers 61 and also 76. And if you're hearing that banging in the background, we're currently under maintenance right now, so we're kind of working what we can here, so just bear with us here. And then our another weather special weather statement here that I was just talking to you about, this is going to be for parts of Hartsville, where we could see some gusty winds that could knock down some tree limbs and blow around unsecured objects. So if you have any unsecure objects out there right now, definitely bring those inside if you can. Put them in the garage or wherever you think is safe. The track of this is moving north at 10 miles per hour. Winds are in excess of 30 miles per hour within this area right here. All right, so it's moving up north. All right, and then this one, like I said, the tracks of it, it's moving northeast at 20 miles per hour. And that line was extending from near Nashville to near Walter Hill. All right. And again, the tracks of it is moving due northeast at 20 miles per hour. We don't have any current flood advisories, flash flood warnings or anything like that. But I will mention to you that we do have a flash flood watch that is out until 1 a.m. Going into Wednesday morning, so we're going to stay weather aware with that. And then also, we're going to watch for possible any other severe thunderstorm watches or tornado watches. We're going to watch both of those carefully over the next couple of hours, during the overnight hours as well, just to see if maybe the National Weather Service will go ahead and issue something along the way. That way, we can keep you informed and aware. That is the latest update
on your Facebook Live here. We are going to send you back to regular scheduled programming. Remember, stay safe out there. Do not try to drive through flooded roadways. I promise you, it's not going to happen. I'm telling you. A lot of cars do not make it around that time. So again, if you are out and about and you hear thunder, definitely go indoors. If you see some flooded roadways, don't try to drive through those. And really, if you don't have to be out, try not to go out at all. And another thing that's going to be interesting to see here, it's going to be interesting to see how these schools pan out for tomorrow with the threat of rain moving through parts of the area. Maybe we'll have some school closures tomorrow, or maybe some schools will close early. I don't know. We'll have to watch all of that very carefully here, but no need to panic. We'll keep you up to date in the Storm 12 HD Weather Center. But for now, we're going to send you back to regular scheduled programming.